Hi everybody, this is Priyanka and welcome back to my channel. Today I am in the gorgeous city of Tromsø. Yeah man, we are in Tromsø and we have come here for a vacation. I am inside my hotel room. This is Hotel Comfort Express and we upgraded and we checked in early and now I'm chilling in my room and I am in Tromsø and I'm so happy. So basically Tromsø is a city which is synonymous with Northern Lights. Like everybody and everybody who comes to Tromsø eventually goes for Northern Lights too. That was our plan. Basically, the story behind our trip to Tromsø is that we were supposed to go to Tromsø in the month of March before the coronavirus outbreak, but eventually it clashed just when the lockdown thing happened. It was just overlapping with our trip, so we decided not to risk it and we traveled. We cancelled our tour even before, you know, the lockdown got implemented. We consciously decided not to, you know, take a trip at that point of time. And we cancelled our trip and all our money went down the drain. But again, in September, we decided, let's do it again. We should not lose our hope and we should give it a shot. So again, in September, because the window for watching Northern Lights in Tromsø is between September to March, and the best time in those months also it's around October and March. So we were like, okay, we can't travel outside Norway since because of the coronavirus pandemic. Let's travel within Norway. Let's go to Tromsø. Let's give it a shot to Northern Lights. So we booked our tickets in the month of September for Northern Lights, and we booked a hotel, we booked the flight tickets. It's a 2-hour journey. It took us 2 hours from Oslo to till Tromsø. It was a very comfortable flight, smooth journey. So the thing is, this entire week the weather has been absolutely crap in Tromsø. Not even kidding, because when we were checking the weather forecast and we were tracking the weather for Northern Lights, it was showing that it was absolutely horrible weather forecast because it was raining, snowing and overclouded. The visibility was almost zero. So what we did is we contacted our tour operator. We had chosen Arctic Explorer. So we contacted them and we asked them that please give us, you know, a sincere advice whether it would be feasible for us to travel all the way and be disappointed that we turn up for the tour and we'll be like, we don't get to see the Northern Lights, because in this kind of a weather, the possibility really tanks. So that person was really honest and that's so generous and so kind of him. He really told me that, you know what, this entire week we are canceling the tour because of the coronavirus pandemic. Number one, that also the turnout is turning out to be pretty high. Number two, because of that. Number three, the weather is not conducive for watching Aurora Lights, because you need to have like clear skies, then there's not supposed to be any rain or snow. And looking at what this entire week has been in and around Norway, the chances are pretty grim. But then we are trying to be hopeful, that's how we are cheering ourselves. But then to be very practical, looking at how things are turning out, we don't think that we will be able to see the Northern Lights. So what we did was, before traveling to Tromsø, you have a time frame till when you can cancel your tickets if the Northern Lights weather condition is not feasible, and they will give you a full refund for that. So we cancelled it 2 days before coming here after watching the weather forecast, and we got the refund, and it's going to be like it's going to come back to you in like 3 to 5 days. So that way that's pretty awesome. Like money wise, it shouldn't be a problem. So since our Northern Lights was the driving force behind this entire trip, we were quite disappointed. We were like, should we go to Tromsø? Because that was the reason we wanted to go. But then we were itching to head out of our homes and we wanted a trip really badly. So we were like, so what? Let it be. Even if we don't get to see the Northern Lights, let's explore Tromsø on foot. Let's see how the city is like. And that was like the, you know, kind of a thing that pumped us back, and we were like, okay, fine, let's explore Tromsø. This time we will come again for the Northern Lights trip, because we live in Norway and Norway is like, we are traveling all the time. So even if we don't make it this time, next time we will probably come and we watch Northern Lights. This time around we'll explore the city and we'll show you. So yeah, that's what the plan is. Right now I'm in my hotel room. Where is my husband? Well, Arjun has gone outside. He is in Vinumopole. Vinumopole, what is Vinumopole? Vinumopole is basically the liquor store. He's getting vodka and maybe gin, I don't know. I'll find out what he picks up. So basically he's picking up some snacks and he's picking up some wine, I guess. So he'll be back for tomorrow. We are stocking up for tomorrow's breakfast and some snacks to binge in so that when we are traveling and we get hungry, we have something in bag. So yeah, that's what the plan is. And I'll keep you posted as and when we step out of our hotel rooms, because it's raining outside. It's really windy. And it's pretty cold. So, like, I was prepared for the worst of weathers, but looking outside what the weather is like, let me show you. It's pretty decent. Like, I had worse expectations in my mind. This is my window. And this is how it looks. There is snow-capped terrains right in front of me. It's a bit of dark clouds over sky. And this is the city. There is water body out there. It's beautiful. I'll see you shortly. And we are outside our hotel room right now and we are going for brunch. We picked up a cafe called Cafe Globus. So the weather right now, it's not raining. I'm so happy. The only thing that really bogs me down in Norway is the rains. I can handle snow, I can handle wind, I can handle cold temperatures, but it's just the rain that really, really, you know, gets me anxious. And right now it's not raining, so I am happy. As long as it's not raining, very happy. So we are going to go to Cafe Globus, chill, eat, drink, and hog like a pig. From the restaurant and we had an amazing time. I had Korean kimchi rice cake. It was amazing. And he had Sri Lankan sandwich, which was one of the best sellers, and we tried that. It was amazing as well. The hosts were really nice and warm and the entire ambience was very cozy and we really enjoyed ourselves. So we will recommend Cafe Globus to you guys if you're traveling to Tromsø. And now it started to drizzle a bit and we are heading to Fjellheisen. So what is Fjellheisen? Fjellheisen. Okay, Fjellheisen. Fjellheisen is cable car, cable lift basically. So we are walking, which is a 40-minute walk, around 3 kilometers. We are walking to Fjellheisen and then we are going to take the cable lift and go up, and it will get chilly and it's going to be like freezing up there. That's the reason we are totally, you see me like a snowman right now. And we are going to spend some time there and I'll show you once we reach the Fjellheisen point. It's a walk and this is what Tromsø looks like. It drizzles a bit in between. But then this is like what entire Norway is like. There's nothing new about this. So you have to get used to this kind of weather by now. The only trouble is when it visibility decreases or it's really windy or it starts pouring like dog cats and dogs, then that's a problem. As long as that those adverse conditions don't start showing, we are pretty good. So right now we are walking on foot and we are exploring the city because that's what exactly we came for. Yes. What all do they have?
Sugar.
What is this?
Sugar is Sarah.
Ice cream. Okay. We are having a hot coffee and we are heading towards Fjellheisen. Fjellheisen, right? Fjellheisen. Have to get the pronunciation right. And while we are walking towards Fjellheisen, see where we ended up. This is where we are right now. And it reminds me of Trondheim because it looks like Trondheim Square. And there is sea out there. Let's take you towards the sea. Arji, let's go towards that side. It's splendid. It's amazing. The mountains are totally snow-capped and this is the thing that I told you in the morning. Aurora Explorer. This is the cruise that takes you for the Northern Lights tour. Can you guys see the name? It says Aurora Explorer. And there's another one behind this. Should we go?
Yeah.
So he is handling the Google directions and I'm handling the GoPro. We have our departments fixed. Let's go. Okay, on our way to the Fjellheisen, change of plans. It's really getting cold and it's not like normal cold, it's getting really cold. So we decided to take a bus. Like 15 minutes into the walk, we decided to take a bus and we are at this station called Skippergata and we are taking bus number 26 to Tromsø. Okay, this is the board and we are going towards Tromsø bus. I thought walk would be easy. It would have been easier had it not been raining, had it just been cold, but it's not only cold, it's also raining. So it's getting a bit little tough. We even had coffee thinking that things will better up, but it's not bettering up. So here it is. Got off the bus. Now we are walking towards the cable car. Fjellheisen. We're trying to figure out where is it, and we are nearby. We are walking up slope and we are almost there. Now I look like a snow panda because I'm going to meet polar bears, so I'm looking like a snow panda. Match of the two titans. Oh, look at the road. It's like there's nobody there. Empty streets and the majestic hills of Tromsø. And I can see a Fjellheisen born. We are there. So we're just testing our luck, which is empty. But but since we're there in Tromsø, and we had to go get out of the home, and we told ourselves let's just do it. We just went with the Nike hat, and we told ourselves let's do it. So we flew down to Tromsø. Yeah, not bad. It's closed? Is it closed?
No.
Are they running? I don't even see a single cable car. Like there. I don't see even a single bird, mosquito. There is nothing out there. Haunting of the cable chair. Part 3. So it's 2:30 and we are inside the cable car kiosk area. We just bought 2 tickets online. So every half an hour the cable car runs, and the next one is at 3 o'clock. It's 2:35 p.m. right now, and it's, thank God we got inside. It's freezing cold and I can only wonder what's happening upstairs, up at the top. It might be very freezing, like I'll freeze to death, but then I have to risk it. This is what exactly I came for. I signed up for this. So we are finally here, and we are waiting for a cable car to start, and this is how it looks. It's gonna run in the next 5 minutes, and we are going to go up right at top of that mountain. Oh, it's very foggy, visibility is pretty low, and I'm sure it's gonna be dead chilly out there. And he's being a very responsible citizen by sanitizing his hands. So yeah, we are waiting for this cable car to start. For a bit, but it's still freezing cold, and it's a gorgeous view. We're actually in between glaciers. This, the view that you can't see, it's all foggy. It's actually mountains, snow-capped mountains, and there's a glacier melting at the back. It's all snow-capped terrain. it's like nature in its most raw and most pure form. It's like the untouched beauty we keep reading about. It's like that. And we are walking through these pavements and we're trying to figure out the way we're going to go as soon as possible without getting ourselves killed. Inside Fjellheisen, and we are sitting in a restaurant and we just had a cup of hot chocolate and Oreo cake. We just gobbled it up. It's empty and this is my hot cup of chocolate. We just had it and it was very yum. So the thing is, we went at the top and it was snowing like crazy up there. It's freezing cold, bad luck, we couldn't stay there for long, but then we can always, you know, come in, come go out, come in, go out. We can do that just to catch a little bit of warmth inside of the restaurant. So this vicinity and this entire area is pretty good, I would say. And the place we are sitting, the restaurant, the view that we're getting off is like of entire Tromsø city, which is wonderful. It's like a panoramic mode that we get to see in the entire city. There's a Tromsø bridge, we can spot the airport, we can spot the church. So let me show you the gorgeous view that we are getting to experience and observe. This is city of Tromsø. And if you guys can see, what I can see with my bare naked eyes is there is a thin line connecting over the water body. If you can see, that's a bridge, the water body connecting the two land masses. That's the Tromsø bridge, and this gives us a wonderful view of entire Tromsø city. RG, how was it up on the Fjellheisen cable car, the entire view?
It was really nice. It's a shame that it was snowing, but still great views nonetheless. Once in a lifetime experience here in the Arctic Circle.
So you like it?
Yeah, it's nice.
Any advice would you like to give to anybody coming to Tromsø?
check the weather.
Always check the weather.
It's kind of a double-edged sword because the flights become really expensive if you don't plan well in advance, and if you plan well in advance then you're kind of leaving it up to luck, hoping that the weather's going to be fine on the couple or three, 4 days that you plan to visit. But I guess whenever you visit Tromsø, everyone says never keep a short trip, always have at least 4 or 5 days. So
even if you have a couple of bad days of experience, you can always make it up in the later days.
Exactly.
So never travel on a short trip to Tromsø. Keep a couple of days handy, like a, you know, like a backup.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a good tip. Come for a long, you know, longer haul. Don't come for a short hopping trip. That's gonna, you know, you're gonna regret that. Hi guys, and this is night time in Tromsø. Sorry, I couldn't update you guys after reaching down from Fjellheisen because it started pouring, it started snowing, it was very windy, it was very chilly, so it was very difficult for us to record. But now that I am back in my hotel and I'm heading out again during dinner time, it's around 8:30 and we are heading out to grab some dinner. We haven't decided where we're supposed to go. We have zeroed on a couple of places, but then we felt like having kebab, we felt like having a burger, and we couldn't really make up our mind. So we were like, okay, fine, let's go out, explore the city a bit, and you never know where we'll head in. So yeah, we are out, it's drizzling, and we are all decked up in our woolens, bundled up, and we're going out and we're going to explore something, and I'll let you know as and where we go. Right now, the city of Tromsø looks like this. This is the late night scene. Not really late night, it's 8:30, it's not really late night, but as per Norway standards, it's late night. Because usually most of the things are shut after 7:30. So if you are planning to stay out till midnight, that's not a good idea. People usually have early dinners in most of Norway. So you gotta be a bit careful with your aspirations. You wanna read a lot, check out a lot, explore a lot. And as you guys can see, I hope you guys can see because I can. I hope the camera is able to capture it. It's raining, it's pouring badly. And we are exploring the streets of Tromsø. I really wanted to show you guys how the daytime looks like, but then we walked back till our hotel room from Fjellheisen. It was around 3 kilometers, and I loved it because we walked using the Tromsø bridge over the sea, and it was exciting. It was quite thrilling. It was windy, it was pouring, so it had all the elements of adventure, but then I couldn't capture it because it was freezing cold. Had the weather been conducive, I could have shown you, but nonetheless, I'm back. So our day today has been pretty good. Coming from a place where we were planning not to come to Tromsø at all, to coming here and actually exploring things beyond Northern Lights, I cannot be complaining. I had a good time. So yeah, we have a planned an itinerary for tomorrow. We have things to do tomorrow. We're going to explore couple of museums, and we are planning to go to a couple of breweries. So yeah, it's going to be an exciting weekend in Tromsø, and I will keep you posted, and let's see where we end up, if we end up at all tonight in a dinner place. I hope we don't end up with a takeaway. That will be like me, but then let's see, fingers crossed. So we are back from Burger King because most of the restaurants are shut in Tromsø by 9, early night. So we headed outside around 8:30, and by the time we went there, most of the restaurants were shut. So we really didn't have many of the options. So whatever little was left, we had to choose. And whatever, the Burger King was the only familiar option out there and near to our hotel, which we saw when we went with it. So we have to go for a fine dining restaurant or for lunch or a dinner. So we might do it tomorrow, and we'll make sure that we leave early. The only thing that stays late open in Tromsø is probably the bars. But we got alcohol from Vinmonopolet by afternoon. So we were drinking inside and we just went out to eat. So that's the balance. That's the smart move that we made. Day two in Tromsø. So it's Saturday, 12 in the noon, and the weather is better than yesterday. It's still not that great, but it's still better. So we are going to Polaris, which is an aquarium, and I hope to see some cute little seals there. As you can see, I'm in right in front of the sea, and there is glaciers and there's mountains and it's totally snow-capped. But yeah, there's one more update. We are trying our luck for Northern Lights, and we're speaking to tour operators. We even had a word at our reception if we can make it. So we are trying to grab a word and get some knowledge and try our luck. So I'm not really sure what's going to happen. So we have to stay tuned whether we are going there, we are not going there. I will not reveal it. So in the meanwhile, till that happens, right now, let's go to Polaris, which is a beautiful aquarium in Tromsø, and let's go. It's Saturday noon. And where are we standing? We are standing in front of Polaria. What is Polaria? Polaria is an aquarium in the city of Tromsø. As you guys can see, I'm standing right in front of Polaria. That's the Polaria building. This is the shipwreck. Behind the shipwreck, you can see are the snow-capped mountains and glaciers. White blanket of snow. What a body. Ships, fresh air, seagulls. How beautiful is this?
Okay, so it's a life to watch the
what movie?
Small.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Where's the theater?
We are out of Aurora in Tromsø. We went there to grab a beer. It's a very nice microbrewery in Tromsø. So if you're going to Tromsø, do make it a point. You check out a very popular, check out Aurora in Tromsø. We liked it, so we'll recommend. And the surprise package for today is that we are going to Northern Lights. Yes, we are going to Northern Lights. We were like trying to get in contact with a lot of tour operators. We were asking people the reception. We're tracking the weather forecast, as I told you guys. And right now, between 6 to 9 p.m., it's saying go, which I already shared it with you. So weather looks very feasible. The clear sky is absolutely cleared up. So we contacted a couple of tour operators, and one of them told us that due to low capacity, no turnout, she refunded our money. But then she reconnected us with another tour that is running today, and they wanted a couple of more people to fill in. They had the capacity, and now we are going to Northern Lights with this tour company called Greenlanders. So we have we are going at 5:50. They will pick us up from our hotel, and everything is being provided, right from thermal suits, boots, food, pictures included. So we are quite happy. This is all like a last moment plan. We were not planning this. We didn't have in our mind that probably Northern Lights will be happening for us during this tour. We just wanted to go to Tromsø for the heck of it, because we had non-refundable flight tickets, non-refundable hotel room prices. So we just took our chance. We just traveled to Tromsø because we had already paid. And thankfully, out of the blue, I don't know how, the weather just cleared up today. Till yesterday, it was all dark, cloudy, raining, snowing, slurpy kind of a weather. And it was very gloomy. But today, everything has cleared up. And that is the thing about Norway as a whole. The weather is very unpredictable and volatile. And so right now, the weather is very nice. The weather gods have been kind. And we are going for another light. It's going to be around 6 to 9 hours. Usually, there are so many tour companies running in Norway, in Tromsø. So you have so many options. Pick one, pick a good reliable one from TripAdvisor. That's where we picked our one from. So what else? You have minibuses running, you have cars running. Pick your whatever suits your budget requirements, go with that and pray to weather gods. Yeah. And I'm happy. And I really pray to God we're able to see Northern Lights because I'm desperately wanting to see it. Because we went to Polaria and we saw a mini movie, and there was a mini movie running on Northern Lights, and it only got me more itching to see Northern Lights. And finally, after a lot of hacks, a lot of contacts, a lot of emails exchanged, we're going to Northern Lights, and we're going right now back to into our hotel room to change and bundle up even more. So right now I'm sitting in this mini car and we are going for Northern Lights tour. It's happening. We are a group of six people and we have a wonderful guide, Marcus, and this is the tour company called Greenlanders. It's right now 6 p.m. in the evening and possibility of viewing the Northern Lights looks pretty good, fingers crossed. And I'll keep you updated as and when we leave out of the city. So we have reached a camping spot. We are a group of six people with our tour guide, Marcus, and this is Greenlanders Tour Company. And right now we are an hour away from Tromsø in a place called Laksvann. I hope I'm pronouncing it right. We have found a camping spot and so far so good. The conditions look feasible and conducive and we are positive that we will be able to see beautiful and stunning gorgeous Northern Lights in an hour or two. It's around midnight and we are in middle of nowhere. We have a bonfire running in the background. We saw a little bit of Northern Lights activity in the sky. We got pictures clicked and we have another couple of hours to go and we are hoping that we will get to see it again. We are a group of six people and it has been a wonderful experience so far. And I'll keep you posted as and when we see more of the activity. We are back in the room and I want to tell you guys that we had an amazing time at the Northern Lights. Our tour guide operator was amazing and our entire trip was brilliant. We left at around 5:50. We got the pickup point was our hotel room. He came to pick us up at our hotel and we came back in the room, which is right now it's 2 a.m. in the night. So 6:30, 7:30, 8:30, 9:30, 10:30, 11:30, 12:30, 1:30. Around 8.5 hours. So our entire tour was for around 8.5 hours. And we saw Northern Lights after 11 p.m. So after like for 3-4 hours, after we went for the trip, we saw Northern Lights. Usually the peak activity period is between 8 p.m. to 11 p.m. That's what a tour guide told us. But today was one of those unusual days when we got to see Northern Lights after 11 p.m. and it was there out in the sky dancing, twirling, curling for good hour and a half. And it was just spreading all over the sky very rapidly. And it was so evident to the eyes. We saw hinges and tinges of purple, pink, green. It was beautiful. It looked like a rainbow. When he was clicking in his professional DSLR and he was showing us the pictures, even he was pretty amazed because he told us that the purple hue that was coming in the pictures is not that, it's not that easily, you know, spotted. So it happens only once in a while that something so purplish happens. And he said that the tinge that was showing, he's like, in his 8 years of his career of chasing Northern Lights, he was like, this is the first time I'm seeing something like this. So it was one of, for the first time in his career as well. So that only got us more related, that it was really special. It was wonderful. Something that it was an experience that words cannot describe, because it's something that you have to experience for it to, you know, to know what's the whole hue, what's the whole fuss about, what's got it so hyped up. So once we saw it and we were in complete awe of this phenomenon, because it was something so magnificent that we were like little kids awestruck towards eyes, you know, eyes stuck onto the sky. Till 11 p.m. we could so see bleak streaks of Northern Lights in the sky, but after Northern Lights, oh boy, it was like all over the sky in every possible direction, and you couldn't know where to look because it was just everywhere in the sky. So yeah, it was wonderful. I'll show you pictures in the end of the video. Those were clicked by those. The pictures that I will be seeing after the video will be the ones clicked by the photographer. And we had a wonderful bonfire. We had an amazing soup. We had cookies. We had hot chocolate. And we had some nice biscuits. So and we were a group of 6 people from all different parts of the world. There was a proposal. We saw a live proposal happening. So it was wonderful. Like, you think of every element possible and we got to experience it. And so even though I'm dead tired right now and I'm just itching to just jump into my bed and pull up the blanket, but right now I had to put this out there, as in I have experienced it firsthand right now. Just I've come back from the tour and I want to tell you guys that if you're there in Tromsø, I'm telling you from my own experience, till yesterday I had no plans, I had no hopes up that I will be today here sitting in this position and talking about Northern Lights, because it was not part of the itinerary. But today we just thought that let's give it a dying fight, let's not give up. Who knows, you know, knocking the windows, the window of opportunity might open up and we might just get lucky. And it actually happened. We not only glided into a tour that was happening, but we also got to see the Northern Lights, which was not usually happens, you know, between 8 to 11 hours in the night. That's when the peak activity happens. We didn't even see in that time. We could have even given up at that time, but even though we got, you know, we put in so much of efforts for this, we didn't get to see it. But then after 11, between 11 to 1 a.m., that midnight period, the activity was absolutely high, and it was amazing how beautiful this entire experience has been. We took the cable car. Like, we had a little bit of everything. So I can't be complaining, because the funny thing is that when I went to a shop day before yesterday on 16th, that Saturday, on Friday, basically, I went to a store and I wanted to take some little souvenirs. I grabbed a kitchen magnet and it had a cable car in it. I didn't grab, there were a couple of different designs there. It had another lights as well, but it was there somewhere within me that I didn't go to another line, so I don't deserve it. I shouldn't be buying another lights fridge magnet. I got a cable car one. But then we ended up going to Dreamy lights yesterday, and that's how crazy and unpredictable it is in Tromsø. So yeah, it is unpredictable in Tromsø. So do try your luck. Don't give up. Even if it's raining and snowing a day before, things go dramatic here. That's all for today, and this was a little tour guide and a little travel blog from the city of Tromsø. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did, as adventurous and crazy it was. Please don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel, and if you have any suggestions, comments, please feel free and comment below. Till my next little adventure and escapade, bye bye.